Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the View Scheduler component. The View Scheduler, also known as a View Event Calendar, is used to manage time efficiently by scheduling and rescheduling events or appointments through editor pop-ups, drag and drop, and resizing actions. Now, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's View Scheduler component to a View project, bind JSON and remote data sources, and work with the component's basic features. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a View project using the View CLI tool. I will then edit my code using Visual Studio and view the output on a supported browser. Along with this, I also install View Class Component Library to use class syntax in the View project. First, I open Visual Studio Code. I need to install the View CLI tool globally on my machine using the command npm install -g at view/cli. As I have already installed it in my machine, I am skipping this step here. I create a new View project using the command view create project name. I named my project Scheduler Component. This will create an empty View application with no Syncfusion packages. I navigate to the newly created application folder. Next, I need to install the View Class Component Library using the command npm install view class component with the version. To start using the View Scheduler component within this application, I need to install the scheduler package and its dependencies using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2viewschedule --save. This command will install the scheduler package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, my application is ready to use the scheduler component. The first thing I need to do is register the scheduler component. I open the app.view file, import the scheduler component from the Syncfusion View Schedule package, and declare the scheduler component inside the component property. To start using the scheduler component, within the template section, I define the EJS schedule tag with height property inside the division element. Next, I open the main file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the trial license key using the register license method. Syncfusion View license key registration is required from volume 12022 onwards. I need to import the necessary scheduler view modules before I start to use the view scheduler. Each scheduler's views are maintained as separate modules within the scheduler repository. It has many built-in views, and I am going to import some basic views, the day, week, workweek, month, and agenda views from the Syncfusion View Schedule package and inject them in the provide option. Next, I need to define the CSS for View Scheduler, so I import the material theme under the style section. Okay, let me save the application and run it with the command npm run serve. This starts the development server and automatically reloads the page anytime when I make edits to my project. Now, you can see the empty scheduler displaying the entire 24 hours with the views, day, week, workweek, month, and agenda. It highlights my current system date in its current view. Here, the default view is week. But, if I want to load the scheduler with some other view, I use the current view property. I define the current view property with the value month inside the scheduler component. You can see in the output that the month view is the current view. As you know, the scheduler loads the system's current date by default. To change it to load with some other date value, define the variable scheduler selected date with the specific date value and assign this variable to the selected date property. See in the output now, the scheduler loads the selected date in the month view. Next, I will show you how to add appointments. First, I define a variable named appointment data with the data source property. Then, I assign the array of event objects with valid event fields to the data source property. I have set the start and end time values, which is enough to create an appointment. So, now I assign this appointment data object to the event settings property of scheduler. Checking the view scheduler component now, you can see the appointment on the given time range. Here, the appointment subject is displayed with its default value add title. To set a title for the appointment, I can add a subject field with an appropriate value inside the DataSource property. Now, the event shows the subject. Next, I will show you how to bind a remote data source to the view scheduler. I use of Data Manager. The Data Manager acts as a gateway between the scheduler and data source and uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. So, as a first step, I import the Data Manager and required adapter from the SyncFusion EJ2 data repository. Then, I define an instance named Remote Data for the Data Manager with the properties URL, adapter, and cross domain. In the URL, I use the already available remote URL service, which retrieves the list of data points through a POST action and then binds the data to the scheduler. This remote URL service will return a collection of data objects with these valid fields. Also, I have set the Web API adapter here, as the URL is already assigned with the existing Web API service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Then, I assign this Data Manager instance to the data source property of the scheduler. Next, I will remove the selected date property from scheduler component because the appointment of this service is available from the date that lies in the month August 2022. You can see the scheduler is loaded with appointments retrieved from the remote data source. In this video, we have seen how to add the SyncFusion View Scheduler component to a view application, change the default date and view in it, and add simple appointments. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire view component suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.